I have harvested the garlic and now it's time to do something with it. I can't make braids out of these because this is hardneck garlic. That's the only type of garlic I grew this year. But I can make bundles. First of all, we need to tidy it up a bit. I start by trimming off all the roots. I gave them a good wash when I dug them out of the garden. And then I get off all the dead stuff. There you go. That's ready. It doesn't take long to trim them all off. This has only taken me 5 minutes to do all these. Once you get a rhythm happening, you're all good. I did find one here that had been damaged when I was digging it up. I put that one aside and we'll use that sooner rather than later. These cloves here, there are two cloves that are damaged. When we come to use them, I'll just ease them out and send them to the compost heap, and the rest of the bulb will be fine. And all this detritus will go back into the compost heap, or I'll probably even use it as mulch on the garden beds themselves. Now I just need to choose where to start. Start with a large bulb, give it a crisscross over. That's another largeage. It's a bit like a jigsaw puzzle. That might be better. When you have your first three, secure it with a piece of string. You need to tie it quite tightly because as these dry out, they will shrink. I just wrapped the string around it a couple more times to make it a little bit more secure. And then from there, you choose some garlic bulbs that will fit nicely. Give that a wrap around. As I said, it needs to be tight. I'll even finish off with this big one. I reckon I could get one more in there. There you go, that'll look good. And then come up your stalks. As far as you like. Remembering to go as tight as you can because this will shrink. Give it a bit of a tail, and then thread that through somewhere. I'll have to thread at the front, I think. It's a bit frayed. Do you really need to do this? No, hardneck garlic can be just stored loose. In fact, that's what I did last year. But I got a bit excited this year and wanted to do braiding until I realised that that's only suitable for softneck garlic, which I didn't grow any of. There you go, so a bit gappy there. No, it's nice and secure, so I do have a gap. I could even, there you go, created a bit of a tail. So I can add that in. I'm just doing it for the looks of it. If you're going to store it loose, just trim the neck of the garlic about 2 inches or a bit less. The end of my string is getting quite frayed now, so it's hard to thread, but I want to make sure that's nice and secure. I did make a tail because I wanted to make a loop to hang it with, but I'll have to make that separately now that I've gone and used with the tail to add that other bulb. That's better. Now I'm getting somewhere. Uh-oh, dog's having a bark. What's your story, Becky? Hey? There you go. That looks all right. I mean, you could even put something there if you wanted to, but if it hang it that way, it looks fine. Then you just trim this off to whatever height you want or length that you want. That's for the garden. And there you go. You can have that sitting quite nicely. Because I added that last one so late in the process, I've put another bit of string around here to secure it, because it was only secured up here, but now it's secured down there, so that's not going to go anywhere. I can trim these bits off, and then I can put some string underneath it to hang it. This variety is called Brown Tempest. It stores for 6 to 8 months. Garlic will take 6 to 8 weeks to reach its full flavour. You can use it now, and we're using the damaged bulbs already. Its best use is for sautéing and slow food, but really, you can use any garlic for anything. It's just some of the really intense ones are probably a bit much for eating raw.